Good evening. My name is Hector Martinez. I am from Mexico. I work in the University of Michoacán de San Nicolás de Hidalgo. My work is about a study of some physicochemical properties, sensory evaluation, and shelf life of freeze-dried yogurt made with skimmed milk, inulin, and Saccharomyces boulardii. This is a ready-to-eat product, only to add some water, and we obtain a liquid yogurt. The yogurt is a food produced as a result of fermenting milk with one or more bacterial cultures that contain the lactic acid-producing bacteria, such as Lactobacillus bulgaricus and Streptococcus thermophilus, according to Food and Drug Administration in 2014. Probiotics. The word probiotics means for life. And the internationally endorsed definition of probiotic is live microorganism that, when administered in adequate amounts, 1 by 10 at power of 7 feet per milliliter, confers health benefits on the host. Different types of products, such as yogurt, had been proposed as carriers for probiotic microorganisms in foods, by which consumers could ingest large amounts of probiotic cells for their therapeutic effect. One of the microorganisms used is a yeast, is the Saccharomyces boulardii. Saccharomyces boulardii is a natural yeast isolated from the bark of the lychee tree in Indochina. And Saccharomyces boulardii is protected in the intestine against Clostridium difficile and cholera toxins. It's effective in preventing antibiotic-induced diarrhea, decrease inflammation, and inhibit bacteria toxins. However, microorganisms that are used as probiotics not always arrive to the colon because they can diet during the transit in the GI. For this reason, some techniques are used to protect the microorganisms used as probiotics. One of the techniques is the microencapsulation. It's a method used to improve the survival of microorganisms. We can see this capsule that contains inside the microorganism. And the microencapsulation is a technique in which liquid droplets are covered by a porous polymeric film, such as alginate, ketosan, starch, gelatin, etc., that contained an active substance, for example, Saccharomyces boulardii. Then the objective of this work was to develop two formula of freeze-dried yogurt obtained with skimmed milk containing vegetable oil, inulin, and Saccharomyces boulardii. We start with a milk without fat, and we replace the fat with vegetable oil, and we add inulin to improve the texture of the product. The first formula had the yeast added as free cells, and the second formula had the yeast added in microencapsulated form. Raw material. We use siluette milk with only 0.2% fat, We use a lactic culture from Danisco that contains Lactobacillus delbrueckii, subspecies bulgaricus, and Streptococcus alvarius, subspecies thermophilus. We use also the Saccharomyces boulardii and inulin obtained from Agave tequilana, subspecies Weber blue bayerti, which contains 97% of inulin and 3% of fructose. Finally, we use the palm oil supplied by Aarhus Carham Company. The first stage to produce the yogurt was to grow the Saccharomyces boulardii. Then we microencapsulate the microorganisms. After that, we elaborate the yogurt based on inulin, palm oil, and Saccharomyces boulardii, either microencapsulated as a free cells. Then we freeze dried the yogurt, and we did some physicochemical and chemical analysis and sensory evaluation. After that, we did a study of accelerated shelf life of the product. We have three products. One, the control, that was yogurt with inulin plus palm oil added. F2 is yogurt and inulin and palm oil and 0.5% of Saccharomyces boulardii. The third product is yogurt with inulin, palm oil, and 0.5% of Saccharomyces boulardii microencapsulated. We can see the liquid yogurt and the freeze-dried yogurt. We proceed to the characterization. We did a physicochemical analysis such as pH and acidity, chemical composition, moisture, mineral, lipid, protein, carbohydrate, and fatty acid profile. We did sensory analysis based on a hedonic scale on 5 points, color, odor, flavor, and texture. Finally, we packet the freeze-dried yogurt in order to make the accelerated shelf life. 25 grams of each sample were placed in metallic bags and stored at 35 degrees centigrade in an incubator. After that, the samples were monitored at 0, 3, 6, 9, 13, 17, and 21 days. After that, we proceed to a microbiological enumeration of Saccharomyces boulardii. Results. We can see the capsules obtained in this work. We obtain an average size of 9 micrometers. We use the ionic emulsion technique using sodium alginate blended with mucilage from Opuntia ficus indica. In table one, we can see the viability of the yeast in the freeze-dried product, comparing the fresh yogurt with freeze-dried yogurt. We can see the difference in F2 that corresponds to fresh yogurt and F3 that corresponds to freeze-dried yogurt was minimal and was not statistically different. Again, we have the three products, F1, F2, and F3. And we did the analysis of pH and acidity. The pH ranged from 4.43 to 4.51. pH range of yogurt contribute to a a better hydration of proteins together with the consistency of the yogurt. Yogurt must have a minimum acidity of 0.5%, and all our products that we obtain appropriate values of acidity, around 0.8%. In table three, we can see the chemical composition of yogurt in moisture, protein, fat, minerals, and carbohydrate. It's not a difference observed. The only difference is in the fat content. It's in the fat content. Yes, this is okay. An increase was observed in the lipid content in F3 as compared to F1 and F2 because during the incorporation of lipid during the microencapsulation process, the lipid was introduced in the product. We use the ionic emulsion water fat process to encapsulate the microorganisms, and we use oil. This is the reason of the higher content of the F3 product in fat. In table four, we can see the fatty acid profile in yogurt samples. We have three sections, the saturated fatty acid, the second monounsaturated fatty acid, and the third section, polyunsaturated fatty acid. We can see the content of fat in cow milk, that the saturated fatty acid is higher as compared to the product. And we replace the fat from cow milk with palm oil. For this reason, we obtain decreasing values of the saturated fat. Additionally, we cannot observe, we don't have the presence of cholesterol that is contained in the fat from cow milk. The monounsaturated fatty acid, we can see the value of 30% in fat, and we can see how the values of monounsaturated increased in F1, F2, and F3 products. We can see the increasing values of oleic acid in the three products as compared to the fat from cow milk. In the polyunsaturated, we can see also a low content of polyunsaturated in fat in cow milk, and how the we can see how the value increases in all products. Particularly, it's important to mention the increase in linoleic acid, omega 6, and alpha linolenic, that is omega 3. We did a sensory analysis of the different yogurts, where phi is the highest favorable attribute evaluated. We can see some interesting scores in F2 and F3 products, similar to the color presented by the control. And the same value in odor in F3 as compared to the control. And we have in F2 a good value for F2, similar to F1. The main differences were found in texture of the product, because in the attributes of texture, evaluator detected the microcapsules in the F3 product, which contributed to give a lower response. And in the general appearance, the difference was minimal in the three products. Finally, I present the accelerated shelf life of the product. We can see in F2, in line green color, the F2 product, and in blue line, the F3 product. We can see the same tendency to decrease. As a function of the days, we have 21 days, but the real value is different because considering that the temperature of 25 degrees centigrade, the value of Q10 is 1 unit, and a temperature of 10 degrees more, higher, of 35 degrees centigrade, this corresponds a Q10 of 2 units. Then this value is 2, and 1 day corresponds to 4 days. This means that the test increase in days. In F2, a count of 7.12 logarithm unit of CUF per gram was found, and after 17 days in F2, that corresponds to 68 days, we have a value of 4.66 log CUF per gram. In F3, the blue line, we start with a count of 6.65 log CUF per gram. And at day 21, we observe that corresponds to 84 days. We obtain a value of 4.40 log CUF per gram. Then the viability loss of Saccharomyces boulardii was in F2 of 3.92 units, and in F3 of 2.15 log units. In conclusion, we were able to formulate a yogurt by replacing milk, fat with palm oil, inulin, and Saccharomyces boulardii without affecting either physicochemical characteristics or viability of the probiotics agent. Thanks.
Yes. And you mentioned the database on the microbial count.
Yes.
Did you calculate it based on percentage? What percentage of it survived after you? What percentage? You calculate it based on percentage.
In this figure? No, not in percentage, only...
No. Above 90% survivor, or you don't?
Yes, around, we have around 90% of survivors. Yes. This study is only, was studied as a function of the growth of the survival of Saccharomyces boulardii. Is not as a function of other characteristics, or for example, oxidative lipids or text or sensory evaluation. Only was for the survival of Saccharomyces boulardii. If I had the product, or what is the question?
You measured the flavor of the milk, the yogurt.
Yes.
Yeah? I want to know how to measure the flavor.
Is this affected by the flavor? The flavor is affected by the addition of Saccharomyces? What was the question?
Right?
Only using a sensory evaluation with panelists. They proved the rehydrate yogurt. We added water to the dried yogurt, and we produced the liquid yogurt. And then we test with the panelists. They proved. And they write the response. Mm-hmm. It was a comparison test of the three products, the control and the yogurt added with the free cells and yogurt added with the Saccharomyces encapsulated. Mm-hmm. But if you observe the results, we have some low values in some characteristics, mainly texture, that was affected because the panelists detected the capsules. What can I do to improve? Oh, the instrument? No. We don't use instrument. It's only a sensory evaluation with panelists. I do not use, for example, a viscometer or texturometer. Only was a sensory evaluation. Yes, with people.
I just want to question myself, what's the size of the capsules?
The size was around 9.2 average size micrometers.
That's quite small, so I was surprised that the panelist could observe them,
that
they could taste them.
Yes, because the capsule is not dissolving in the when we added the water. And they detected some grainy, tiny particles.
And they have the impression that they might agglomerate the larger. I think our students normally have a holy grail number. If something is below 10 microns, we don't notice it. That's not correct.
When we obtain the capsule is an agglomerate of particles. And we wash the capsule, but they remain together. Mm-hmm.